This is the voice of Radio Free Kosovo, brought to you by the Albanian League of Prizren. This week, it's part two of a two-part program dealing with the historical relations of Albanian with other languages. You know, it must be borne in mind that the early lexical coincidences between the Albanian and the Romanian languages have been explained differently by a series of foreign linguists, including some Romanian linguists. In fact, they are words, some of which must have been common to Illyrian and Thracian, to neighboring Indo-European languages, while others must have migrated from the western parts to the eastern parts of the Balkans and vice versa. Worthy of mention here is the opinion of Ekrem Shabe, that while these have remained isolated words in Romanian, in the Albanian language, most of them are not isolated words at all, but make up families of words. This circumstance is evidence of a migration of at least some of these words from the west to the east of the Balkans in the earliest times, that is, before the direct contacts between the ancestors of the Albanians and the Romanians were interrupted by the Slavonic migrations into the Balkan Peninsula. The relations which the Albanian language has had with other languages since its formation, as a qualitatively different language from its mother Illyrian, require special consideration. Here, we refer to its contacts with the Slavonic languages of the Balkans, Greek, Turkish, the Romance, and other languages. The contacts of the Albanian language with the neighboring languages occurred in a period when certain common linguistic phenomena, usually known as Balkanisms, had commenced and developed. Among others, they include the suffixing definite article in the Albanian, Romanian, and Bulgarian Macedonian languages, the formation of the future tense with the auxiliary verb dua, usually in a fixed form such as dote bay in Albanian, and in all the Balkan languages, the replacement of the infinitive by the subjunctive and the repetition of objects through shortened forms of personal pronouns. These common characteristics of the Balkan languages have long attracted the attention of linguists in various countries, who have tried to discover the linguistic and non-linguistic factors which have made possible the development and spread of these Balkanisms. But it is self-evident that the historical clarification of these linguistic phenomena, the beginnings of which are lost in the distant past, presents many difficulties. In this case, the objective difficulties have been increased by difficulties of a subjective character. In this field of studies, prejudices and subjective attitudes must give way to objective historical clarification of facts and the common linguistic characteristics in each of the Balkan languages. Besides this, each Balkanism in this or that separate language must be examined not in isolation, but in close connection with the tendencies of the historical evolution of the respective linguistic system. In this case, too, the establishment of a relatively accurate chronology for each Balkanism in the various languages of the Balkans assumes first-rate importance, because one of the main shortcomings of Balkanological studies can be seen precisely in this. In these studies, sometimes deliberately and sometimes from ignorance of the facts, in many cases, due account has not been taken of the fact that two languages of the Balkans, Albanian and Romanian, for known historical reasons, have a relatively late written documentation, which does not go back beyond the 16th century. But the Balkanisms in these two languages in general are much older than that. Suffice it to mention that the suffixing of the definite article in the Albanian language is an early phenomenon, the beginning of which is lost in the distant past of the history of the language. Nevertheless, some linguist has tried to explain this phenomenon of the Albanian language as a foreign influence. Moreover, as a Slavonic influence, to be exact. Although it has already been established that the placing of the definite article as a suffix is a phenomenon which appeared much later in Bulgarian Macedonian than in the Albanian language, and perhaps not without the influence of neighboring languages. As is known, those who have studied the history of the Albanian language have concentrated their greatest attention on the borrowings this language has accepted, especially from the neighboring languages. And it is true that many words from the Slavonic and Greek languages have entered our language, especially its peripheral dialects, just as many words from the Turkish and Romance languages have done. On the other hand, however, the fact that Albanian has exerted its influence on the neighboring languages, and not only in the field of vocabulary, should not be passed over in silence. Thus, G. Mayer pinpointed about 70 Albanian words that have entered the Greek language. Subsequent comparative studies have brought to light other Albanian borrowings in the Greek language. A similar thing has occurred with the Slavonic languages that have had the most contact with Albanian. Indeed, in the Slavonic dialects of the border areas, influences of the Albanian language can be seen in the field of grammar, too. Thus, in the use of the past perfect tense of the type come arther, have come, in Western Macedonian, which at this point, and at some others, differs from the other Slavonic languages, the influence of the Albanian should not be ruled out. The reciprocal influences between Albanian and the neighboring languages constitute an object of investigation and study of great interest for the history of these languages, as well as for comparative Balkan studies in general. Thorough study of these reciprocal influences is an important contribution to the further clarification of the historical relations between the peoples of the Balkan Peninsula, especially of those early periods from which there are few historical documents or none at all. This concludes our two-part series on the history of the Albanian language as it relates to other languages. Now, let's have some more wonderful Albanian music.